Hello friends, this is Ayush and in this video we'll be discussing quant section of CMAT 2020 paper. We'll be having questions from permutation and combinations, probability, number system, set theory, time and work, time speed distance, mensuration and geometry in this video. So let's begin with it. It's question number one on the screen. The question is from permutation and combination. It's a basic question. In how many ways a committee consisting of 5 men and 6 women can be formed from 8 men and 10 women? So a simple question from combination where we'll have 8 men and we have to select 5, and we have 10 women and out of them we have to select 6 women. The simple formula will be 8C5 for the selection of men multiplied by 10C6 for the selection of women. This will be 8 factorial upon 5 factorial 3 factorial into 10 factorial upon 6 factorial 4 factorial. So this will be 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 factorial upon 5 factorial into 3 factorial is 6 into 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 factorial upon 6 factorial into 24. This will get cancelled out. This 5 factorial and 5 factorial will get cancelled out. 66 will get cancelled out. 9 8 is 72. Which is thrice of 24. So, on multiplying, the values 8 into 7 into 10 into 3 into 7, the result will be 11760. So, option D, 11760 is the correct answer for question number 1. Let's go ahead for the next question, question number 2. What is the farthest distance between two points on a cylinder? So, it's a question from mensuration where a cylinder is given to us. So let me draw a cylinder. Here's the cylinder with the height of the cylinder being 8 and the radius is again 8. Now if this radius is 8, we have to find the farthest distance between any two points of the cylinder. The farthest distance that is possible in case of a cylinder is this diagonal that I have drawn. And if this radius is 8, this whole base diameter will be of 16. So it will form a right angled triangle where the perpendicular is of 8 units, the base is of 16 units, and we have to find the value of hypotenuse. Right? So in that case, applying Pythagoras theorem, h square equal to p square plus b square. So that will be h square equals to 64 plus 256, which on adding will give us 320. So h will be equal to 8. Root 5. So the farthest distance between any two points on a cylinder with the height and radius being 8 each will be 8 root 5. So option A, 8 root 5 is the correct answer for question number 2. Let's go ahead for question number 3. We have to find the smallest number by which 2400 should be divided to make it a perfect cube. Now this is a question from number system where 2400 is being given to us and we have to divide it by a number such that it may result into a perfect cube. So in order to solve this question, what we need to do is we need to prime factorize this 2400, which can be done easily as it can be written as 24 into 100. Now this 24 is 2 cube, that is 8 into 3, and 100 is 2 square into 5 square. That will be 2 raised to the power 5 into 3 raised to the power 1 into 5 raised to the power 2. Now, in order to make this value a perfect cube, we need to remove all the extra values that we have from the given number. So, we need to divide it by 2 raised to the power 2. That will leave 2 raised to the power 3, which is a perfect cube. Again, 3 raised to the power 1 is there, which cannot make a perfect cube. So, we'll divide it by 3 raised to the power 1 as well and 5 raised to the power 2 as well. So, that will be 4 into 3 into 25. So, multiplying, we'll get the number as 300. So in case if we are dividing 2400 by 300, we'll get a perfect cube. We can just take it out. 2400 upon 300 is 8, which is a perfect cube. So the correct answer for question number 3 is option D, that is 300. Let's go ahead for the next question, question number 4. It's a question from set theory. In a certain town, 40% of the people have brown hair and 30% have brown eyes. So the two quantities that are given to us as brown hair and brown eyes. So let me draw two circles for the same. This is brown hair and this is brown eyes. Right. 12% of the people have both brown hairs and brown eyes. So let me fill this common area as 12%. Since 40% were having brown hair, out of which 12% is there, so this should be 28. And brown eyes, with 30% people were there, out of which 12 are here, so it should be 18. We have to find the number of people or the percentage of people who are having neither brown hair nor brown eyes. So ultimately, what we need to find out is this area which is lying outside both the circles. So let me just calculate this. This entire box is of 100, out of which the values that I need to subtract is 28 plus 12 plus 18. So this will be 100 minus 58, which is equals to 42. So 42% of the people were not having brown hair and brown eyes. So the correct answer for question number 4 is option D, that is 42%. Let's go ahead for question number 5. Again, a question from number system. The sum of two numbers is 135 and their HCF is 9. When it is given to us that the HCF of two numbers is 9, we'll assume the numbers to be 9x and 9y. With the condition that x and y should be co-prime. Co-prime means x and y should not have any common factor in between, but both the numbers which add up to 135 should be a multiple of 9, right? So I have assumed the two numbers to be 9x and 9y. 9x plus 9y equal to 135. I'll take 9 common. I'll have x plus y equal to 135 upon 9, which is equals to 15. Now the possible pairs for this is 1, 14, 2, 13, 3, 12, 4, 9, 4, 11, 5 and 10, 6 and 9, 7 and 8. These are the pairs which are possible, but still there is a remaining condition that x and y should never be co-prime. So this is applicable, and 1 and 14 is the correct solution, 2, 13 is correct. 3, 12 is not correct because they are not co-prime. They have a common factor 3. Similarly, 4, 11 is correct. 5, 10 is incorrect because they do have a common factor 5. 6, 9 is again incorrect, and 7, 8 is correct. So we can just take it out. There are four pairs which are following the condition, both the conditions that their HCF is 9 and their sum is 135. So for question number 5, the correct answer should be option C, that is 4. Let's go into the next question. Question number 6 is on the screen. Again, a question from number system. There some algebraic expression is given to us and we need to solve this. So it is 0.3 into 0.3. This can be written as 0.3 square. 0.03 into 0.03, this can be written as 0.03 square minus 0.6 into 0.03. So this can be written as 0.06. So I can write 0.2 into 0.3 into 0.03 upon 0.54. So what I have done is I have reframed the expression into a different form where I have in this is a square, this is b square, this is 2ab, which will give me the formula of a minus b whole square upon 0.54. So this will be 0.27 whole square, which can be written as 0.27 into 0.27 upon 0.54. So on solving, I'll have this as 1 and this as 2. So this will be 0.27 upon 2, which on solving will give me a value of 0.135, which is the correct answer for this question. So for question number 6, the correct answer is option B, that is 0.135. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 7 is on the screen. Again, a question from HCF-LCM, means number system only. The LCM and HCF of two numbers are 84 and 21 respectively. When the given HCF is 21, I can assume the numbers to be 21x and 21y, right? And their LCM is 84. So I can just write it down. First number into second number equal to LCM into HCF, right? So when I solve this, I'll cancel out 21 with 21. I'll have x into y equals to 84 upon 21, that is 4. So I can figure it out that the two numbers x and y, that the product of two numbers should be 4. It can be possible only if we'll have 1 into 4 or 2 into 2. But we cannot have this 2 into 2. Reason being, first of all, they are not co-prime. Also, it is given to us in the question that the ratio of number is 1:4. So we'll obtain the values as x equal to 1 and y equals to 4. So the numbers that we assumed were 21x, that is 21, and 21y, and y equals to 4, so the number is 84. What they have asked is the larger among the two numbers, that will be 84. So option D is the correct answer for question number 7. Question number 8, it's a question from Time and Work. Work done by a man, women and child are in the ratio 3:2:1. So in that case, I can assume child is doing 1 unit, women is doing 2 units, and a man is doing 3 units, right? When 20 men, so that will be 20:3 units, plus 30 women, that is 30:2 units, plus 36 children, that is 36:1 units, are done. So for this will be equals to 60 plus 36. That is 156 units. So for 156 units, they will be paid upon 78 rupees. So for 1 unit, they must have been paid 78 upon 156, which on solving will give us 1 by 2 rupees. Right. What they have asked is, what will be the wages of 15 men? And this is the wages that we have obtained per day. Now we are talking about 15 men, so it's 15:3 units plus 21 women, that's 21:2 units plus 30 children, that's 30:1 unit. So this is the total units that will be done in a day, 45 plus 42 plus 30, which adds up to 117 units. This is per day, and they are asking us the wages for 18 weeks. So, multiplied by 7 for a week and multiplied by 18 for 18 weeks. So, the total units will be 117 × 7 × 18, and the wages per unit per day was rupees 1 by 2. So, for this, they will be paid an amount of this into 1 by 2. So, I'll have cancelling out 2 and 18 by 9. So, we'll have 117 × 7 × 9. So, in this case, we can directly calculate the answer even not by going by the entire calculation, by looking at the unit digit only. 7 × 7 is 49, the unit digit is 9, and 9 × 9 is 81, the unit digit is 1. So, we'll have the answer with the unit digit as 1, and there's only one such option. Option A should be the correct answer for this question. We can even go by the entire method for solving the value 117 × 7 × 9 to get the answer as well. So, for question number 8, the correct answer is option A. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 9 is on the screen. It's a question from Time, Speed and Distance. X and Y are running towards each other from their houses. So let us assume it's X, here it's Y. X can reach Y's house in 25 minutes. So X will take 25 minutes to travel, which is half the time taken by Y to run from his house to X house. This is half the time taken by Y. Matlab, the total time taken by Y will be twice of it, that is 50 minutes. So X will take a total of 25 minutes and Y will take a total of 50 minutes to travel the whole distance. Now if two starts to run towards each other at the same time, then how much more time it will be required by Y to reach the middle of the houses? Now, they both of them, X and Y, are reaching the middle of the houses. So for that, X will be taking half of 25, that is 12.5 minutes, and Y will be taking half of 50, that is 25 minutes. The extra duration or the extra time that Y has taken as compared to X will be 25 minus 12.5, which is equals to 12.5 minutes. So for question number 9, the correct answer is option D, that is 12.5 minutes. Okay, here it's question number 10th on the screen. It's a question from probability. So brother and sister both appear for an interview. The probability for selection of brother is 1 by 8. Brother ke liye selection ka probability is 1 by 8. This is for selection. So rejection ka probability for brother will be 7 by 8. And for sister, the probability of rejection is 4 by 5. So the probability of selection will be 1 by 5. We have to find the probability that only one of them is selected. Only one of them is selected. This case is possible when brother is selected and sister is rejected, or brother is rejected and sister is selected. So let's find out the probability for the same. Brother is selected, the probability is 1 by 8, and means multiply. Sister is rejected, the probability is 4 by 5. Or means addition. Brother is rejected, the probability is 7 by 8, and sister is selected, the probability is 1 by 5. So I'll have 4 by 40 plus 7 by 40, which on adding will give me 11 by 40. So 11 by 40 is the correct answer for this question. Question number 10. The correct answer is option A, that is 11 by 40. Let's go ahead to the next question. That's question number 11. It's a question from competition and combination again. There are 6 teachers. Out of them, 2 are physics teachers. So we have 2 physics teachers. Let them be P1 and P2. There are 2 chemistry teachers. Let them be C1 and C2. And there are 2 mathematics teachers, that is M1 and M2. Now what we have to do is they have to stand in a row so that physics, chemistry and mathematics teacher are always in a set. Always in a set means they should always sit together. So what I'll do is I'll combine the 2 physics teachers together, the 2 chemistry teachers together and the 2 maths teachers together. What I will obtain are 3 different groups. Now these 3 different groups can be arranged in 3 factorial ways. Now talking internally about the first group, having P1 and P2, the rearrangement can be done in 2 factorial ways. Similarly, for the second group of C1 and C2, there are 2 factorial ways to arrange them internally. And for the third group, M1 and N2, there are again 2 factorial ways to arrange them internally. So the total number of ways in which they can be arranged is 6 into 2 into 2 into 2, which on solving will give us 48. So a total of 48 number of ways are there to arrange the 6 teachers as per the conditions given in the question. So for question number 11, option B, 48 is the correct answer. Let's go ahead to the next question, question number 12. It's a question from geometry. Which of the following set of numbers can be used as the length of the side of a triangle? The length of the side of a triangle, there is only one theorem related to the same. That means sum of 2 sides of the triangle, let the 2 sides of the triangle be x and y, should always be greater than the third side of the triangle. Right. So this is the only property applicable on the basis of which we can solve this question. So let's just take it out. For the first case, it's 5, 7 and 12. Where 5 and 7 adds up to 12 and it's not greater than 12. So this set of value can never form a triangle because the sum of 2 sides is not greater than the third side. For the second case, 5, 7 and 9. 5 plus 7 is greater than 9. 7 plus 9 is greater than 5 and 5 plus 9 is greater than 7. So all the 3 situations are possible where sum of any 2 sides of the triangle is greater than the third side. So this should be a correct solution. But still, just for the confirmation, let's check out the other 2 values as well. The third option is 7 plus 9 is less than 17, where it should be greater than 17. So again, it's a wrong option. And 2 plus 4 is less than 10, where it should be greater than to form a triangle. So this is again a wrong answer. So by checking by options for question number 12, the correct option turns out to be option B, that is 5, 7 and 9. Let's go ahead to the next question. Question number 13th is on the screen. It's a question again from permutation and combination. How many different ways can the letter of the words extra be arranged so that vowels are never together? So, in order to find out the ways where vowels are never together, what I'll do is, first of all, I'll calculate the total number of ways in which the letters of the word extra can be arranged. So, there are 5 letters. So, 5 factorial ways are there in which the letters of the word extra can be arranged. Now, I'll subtract the cases when they are occurring together. So, I'll find out the cases where they are not occurring together. So, when we want the vowels to occur together, E and A to be together, I'll put them together and I'll keep X, T and R separately. Now, I'll consider E and A to be a single unit only. So, we'll have 1, 2, 3 and 4 units which can be arranged in 4 factorial ways. And this E and A can internally be arranged in 2 factorial ways. So, 5 factorial minus 24 into 2 is 48. So, 120 minus 48 will give us 72. Which is the correct answer for this question. So for question number 13, option D, 72 is the correct answer. So with this, we are done with all the questions based on the chapter, permutation, combinations, probability, time and work, time, speed, distance, and etc. Right. In case if you have any kind of queries, you can post the queries on our Facebook page. Thank you for watching the video.